I've been so clear of this shit happening on this planet. All the innocent beings that suffer.
Do the math.
through the map. It cost around, it cost around towns to produce 1 pound of meat. To produce 1 pound of meat. 16 pounds of plant products from soy, from mice, to other plant products, and around 2,500 gallons of water. 2,500 gallons of water. 2,500 gallons of water. What is your excuse for apathy? Pleasure or some good or self? Always in the position of the victim if you choose right from wrong. Because if you are not the victim, it becomes pretty easily to mock and accuse your victim. Make fun of your entire existence. But when you are the victim, things look a lot different from that angle. And that's how you choose right and wrong. Animals don't want to be your food choices. You use compassion, logic, and morality. Can we then use that also on people that can't speak our language? Have we tried to abuse them? Awaken, awaken humanity. You are full of straw man arguments. Veganism is in any way a moral to protect cruel traditions. Beliefs and habits are terrible excuses. Just like it was for Sam, the burning of widows from deceased husbands. So was that for slavery. Traditions, beliefs and habits are just what they're being. Some are trampled on the evil, and some are nice, and some be neutral. And there be always that, no matter if they're being believed by one group with 1 second stone. But whatever that one tradition or belief is protected by one group with 1 second, it is also a very bad excuse for slavery, satanism, and a lot of other bad human traditions. And therefore, since animals are 100% innocent, I mean the pigs and turkeys, and humans are the abusers. This mortal logic extends some simple decency and compassion to the by going vegan. een dons. Luister, spier ze je object. Laat test op je en maak goed. Closing our entertainment, you dirty parasitic creatures. My simple coming be, you can be a hero for any living. See nobody do something to stop an atrocity like poverty and science. Veganism is the only way they stand up for what we write. Several days, several times, every day. Simple by your food choices and the clothing you wear. Go vegan. Do not ask for mercy yourself. Just infer to ask for something that you're not willing to give yourself. Mercy and compassion is all. The only is for the ones that be innocent. Since I have alienated myself from most of humans, I can safely say I be not one of you anymore. I be justice. I speak against human prejudice because I be not an anthropocentrist or a human exclusionist. I look at the thing on another recession. It may be crazy for you, but so are the animal, so are the underground railroads that freed the slaves in the West, and so are the break down the cage of Birkenhaus in Auschwitz. In the eyes of the Nazis. If you have to choose between one group or another, you always to choose the side of the weakest. That's always the one thing that the most greatest people in history ever have done. Not siding with the side of the oppressors, but siding with the side of the oppressed head. And that's what we do. And something you can also do. I don't ask you to blow up McDonald's or something like that. I only ask you to change what you eat, where, etc. Only extending some simple decency to the animals we share this planet with. Is that too much to ask from you? I see. Come one day that you have to choose a position that is neither safe, no political correct, is not popular, but your conscience say that it be right, and then you have to stand up for our right and not give an F about what the majority think, because you be right or you be right. The majority is not right because there be the majority. Sometimes anybody is wrong. So don't be afraid to say something that is not popular. Because somebody or some group say that it is not right. Don't mean that it's not being right. Use your brain. Compassion have always to conquer industrialized injustice, evil, violence, and the law is not justice. As long as you not understand that the law is not justice, you will not be a revolutionary. Because laws are always been broken by free-thinking radicals who understand that the laws are injustice and that there is not to work in a violent and immoral system that punish the liberationists.